by the promise of an even comfier one, our own intercity sizzler, Mark Allen, came across another alternative to the Learjet.
Rail transport wasn't too popular a while back. The trains were invariably late, the sandwiches tended to curl up at the corners, but since the very successful We're Getting There campaign, people have been returning to this quaint and traditional form of transport. Even pop stars. Are they really exchanging the luxury of the tour bus for a second-class seat near the buffet? Is this, in fact, an ordinary train? These are the mysteries that only whistle test could unravel. Excuse me, sir, how do you feel about sharing your compartment with these ruffians?
Well, I think it's an invasion of privacy. Pay all this money to come on here, and I'm getting interrupted and everything. I mean, I wouldn't photograph people on trains or anything, and here I am, getting disturbed.
Home on the rain, the ear and the ends of
the whole train. Excuse me, sir, just for a second. As a paying customer, do you mind sharing your carriage with these long-haired pop musicians?
I think it's disgusting. They just lower the tone of the occasion totally. How can one enjoy one's champagne?
I'm going to be a train driver when I grow up.
We are, as you can see, safely aboard, and I'm glad to report that just down the corridor, there are some real live pop stars. I'll finish my soup, and we'll investigate. Excuse me. Gentlemen, if I can just butt in for a moment. Now, you've obviously enjoyed this lavish lunch here. What brings you to be riding on this particular train?
It's the easiest way to get to Venice. And we're supposed to be playing a concert there in 2 days' time, so we thought we'd go on the Orient Express.
Why particularly the Orient Express?
Well, because we've discovered that we always wanted to travel on it. For years and years, and so we thought the best way to go on it was to actually have a reason for the other end, otherwise it just seems like, you know, a very sickly thing to do, really.
Also, the bar's open all day and night.
Did you enjoy the roll of Scotch smoked salmon stuffed with prawns that they've
got on offer today? It got taken away, because I had to sit here doing interviews. They took it away. I had one mouthful.
You tried them?
No.
There are still profiteroles to come, I understand.
Oh, God, I'll make up for it.
It's the strangest breakfast I've had in a long time. Yeah.
And what are you actually doing in Venice when you get there?
Well, we're supposed to be playing in... It's not actually in Venice, in Verona, in the Opera House. And then we've got about 3 days off in Venice. But it's a group holiday, really, because we haven't had one for about 18 months. So this is it.
It's hard life, so we figured we needed a holiday, so...
Will you be doing more train travel after this?
If it's like this, yeah, I'd love to. And we do actually travel by train a lot on tour, because it's nicer than flying, you know, because you can see more of what's going on around you, but it's not usually quite as lavish as this summer.
Apparently you have to dress for dinner on the Orient Express, is that right?
Oh, yes.
You've had to hire suits.
They won't actually let you in the restaurant car unless you're dressed up in a DJ.
We still don't know if they're going to let us in the restaurant car anyway.
Well, look, there's some paying customers down here that are eager to hear some acoustic selections from the set that you're going to be playing at Verona, so if you'd like to oblige.
You just had to have a guitar on the track, Chester.
It was what I made earlier.
Very short one.
You can't hear that.
You won't leave any trace. It's always the same. You jump in someone else's train. Who wants to get long to learn the new smile? You have to adjust. adapt to you, we out of style. It's always the same, you jump in someone else's train.
There you have it. Five more satisfied customers who seem to prefer profiteroles to sausage rolls, and we ask how many more pop musicians will stop going on the road and start letting the train take the strain. Mark Ellen on the Orient Express for Whistletest.